is a drawing of the layout of the buildings. I've been asked quite a lot of questions in the comments about the layout, and people are getting a little bit confused because there's quite a few buildings.
Videoing you, I'm just videoing the plug. That's pretty horrendous, isn't it? So all the covering of those wires is all falling off, isn't it? Ew, oh dear. Yes, very dangerous. Excellent.
Now, we were waiting for things, and now we're no longer waiting for the plasterer. Plasterboarding has been finished. So this is the bathroom in the upstairs apartment. And these are the walls that he was also doing, which we were still waiting on in the upstairs apartment. So these have all been done. Yeah, they've all been filled and sanded. So, some progress. Progress has been made. Yeah, so I'm very pleased about that. Finally, something finished.
So I have to finish my combing, yeah?
Underneath there, just to smooth it off. Now I'm gonna dust it all down. Just make sure it's no loose bits. Yeah. I'm gonna dust it all down, ready to paint it. Now, I thought I was gonna have to strip it. This paint that's on it is pretty solid. So the easiest way to do it is to spray it. So that's what I'm going to try it anyway. If it lifts the paint underneath, then I'll have to strip it off. I'm going to spray it with some gold spray paint, and then I'm going to probably treat it with some wax and a little bit of gold paste. So I'm going to try a few things on it, but firstly I'm going to spray it with the gold spray paint. So I'm going to cover the mirror up and the walls around it. And get on with that. That's my French lesson for the day. Scotch tape.
Yes.
Frequent masking tape. So firstly I'm going to dust it all down. And there's a lot of holes. and it has an insignia up here. It's definitely a B and an A, but I'm not sure if it's A, B or B, A. I'm not quite sure how we would tell that, because they are interlinked. I don't know if it's original to the house. I think it's probably because it was a building family. I think it's probably been brought from a different house where they've done work and pulled things out, because a lot of the panelling you can see is not original. It's been adjusted and used, reused, recycled. So I come from a family of builders, so I know that we acquire things as people change things and take things out, they get reused in other ways. Over the years I've had a few free so-called new kitchens, which obviously weren't new, but to me they were better than the one I had at the time. Washing all this down. Now these are not connected yet. I just wired these up. We bought these. These were just candle holders. I don't know if you can see this.
Yes. Oh, beautiful!
It's a collage.
Yes.
It's
like a baby.
Yes.
Still a little bits of paper.
Thank you.
I need some bigger bits.
Oh, well, there you are.
So.
What can you do?
Yeah.
Oh, Jen, it's beautiful.
Oh. Yeah, I'll leave it like this.
Yeah.
Right, we'll go down and get some plastic bags right at the top there and around the bottom here. Yeah.
Annoying job.
Annoying?
Job.
I think.
Have we done that?
I think rats are more annoying.
Rats?
Rats.
Eat.
Why? Squeak. But they're dirty. This is very clean.
Ah, yes. I agree with you. Yes, of course.
I just pulled down part of the ceiling in the kitchen, and unfortunately, They found some signs. I don't think it's rats, not quite big as rats, but it's some creature that's obviously been in the roof of the temporary kitchen at some point. I don't think it's particularly new, and I definitely haven't seen any evidence of any mice or rats or anything like that in the actual cupboard. But obviously, as they've pulled it down, it's gone all over the kitchen floor. So they've had to clean it all up, and then we're going to have to disinfect it. So yeah, one of the pitfalls of living in a place like this, we're going to have mice and creatures. Yeah, I don't think they've moved in permanently. Not yet. Pretty. I'm nearly there with the masking up, sheeting up. I need a holster tone. Oh.
Yes.
I need a holster like the cowboys have. So yes. I have one in each pocket. Two guns. Anyway, I'll peep out of here if I'm shooting for a minute. What are you after?
Pate.
Pat, you mean. Doesn't have an accent on that one. It's not in here, is it?
No.
No. Okay. We'll use one at a time, but yeah, that'd be good, isn't it?
You all ready? There you go.
Yes, I need out and shut the door, please.
Yes. Okay, the men outside and the women inside, okay. Jump me to
Look, this is a draft, you see. I've got the windows open for the air, but I don't really want a big draft.
You shut the door?
Yes, please. Oh, bye!
One second.
Oh, time! Anyway, I've got a couple of gloves on. And one mask. Alright. Just tell me.
Can you go?
Yes, certainly.
I hope the cat is going to be out. I think it's quite good at the burger.
this I've had over the years.
As we can see, it's completely covered the blue, which is exactly what we wanted it to do. And I think it's brought out the detail very well, but unfortunately it makes it look too new. So now I'm going to not distress it, but I'm going to try to fill in the little details a little bit. And what I've got is some blackboard paint. I'm going to dry brush it into the nooks and crannies and then polish it off and see how we go. As you can probably see on the wall, we've actually got the heater on in here, and it's actually quite warm because the rest of the house is a bit chilly at the moment. The idea is for me to take a little bit of my blackboard paint on a brush and then pretty much wipe off what I can on the paper. So this is what we're going to try. Not sure how easy this is going to be to get it into just the cracks. So I'm going to take most of the paint off of there and see what we're left with. Alright, find a little spot. Let's see. Yeah, I'm not going to get it back off again. Alright. Oh, actually, that is actually working very well. Right, I'm happy with that, am I? Yeah. Right, lots of little patches at a time, and wipe it off before it dries, you know? Nice dry brush to take it back off. Yeah, it's a bit softer than the tissue, I think. So, yeah. It's quite an artistic thing. Right. What do you think, Tan?
Very good.
Makes it look older, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay. Also, you want the dark bits to be when the dirt would settle, and little nooks and crannies. Right, I'm going to try and show you a close-up of what I'm doing, but it's going to be very difficult for me to hold the camera and do this at the same time. So, If it wobbles a bit, don't turn me off.
So firstly, what I'm doing is I have a brush, I've dipped it in the black paint, blackboard paint I'm using, and then I've wiped off most of the excess. So there's just almost a little bit of dry paint on the end. Then I'm working this in
to these little mouldings, a little bit at a time, and then with a dry brush,
before it dries, I'm sort of trying to take it back off again, but it's leaving little bits underneath, which is picking out the shape of the mouldings. Then I will go over it again with some highlighter on the top. I'll just show you again on one of these bigger pieces. Actually, if I show you this side, you might get a sense of how new that looks for the moment. And then brush it with the dry black paint. See, there's hardly anything on there, but it's enough to just dull it down enough to bring out the pattern. Then I get my other brush and take off as much as I can off of the top of that. It's just giving it more of an aged feel and bringing out the relief. And then that will be added to again once we put the gold paste on the top. Right, I'm going to put you back up here. There. And I'm going to carry on. Okay, I've done most of the bottom part of the mirror. Now I'm going to work my way up the sides. Exciting things happening out there if the digger survived. So I'll go down and show you that. We'll come back to this later. I will just give you a close up on where I've been so far. You can see where it's bringing out the detail. I'm actually quite pleased with the effect of that. Makes it look a little bit more aged. So you can see a newer bit up there that I haven't touched yet, and then more detail picked out than the one that I have done. It definitely makes a difference. So I'll continue this in a while. And we'll get up to the best bit, which is that bit up the top. So we can see the tractor and trailer parked over the road there in the car park, which is how they've managed to get the digger here. They've brought it on that big trailer. So apparently Adam has arrived with the digger. So we're gonna go and find out what's going on. We've been waiting on a long time because of the weather. Yeah, it has to be videoed, I'm afraid. Yes, the digger has arrived. This is a big event.
Hello.
easy. You were hoping to find some cobbles?
Yeah.
Well, there may be in other areas.
Maybe.
There may be pathways here somewhere. Obviously, we found this pathway we're standing on here, didn't we?
That entrance through the barn press.
Yeah, I think maybe...
Who knows?
Yeah. But even if it's just got all this rocky soil underneath, it's still a decent base, isn't it?
Yeah, that is it. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
It's solid, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, they're going to have a little look somewhere else now. We do like to dig a hole and see what's down there. Ah, I'm going to go and dig over by the barn. Let's go and have a little look. A little bit closer. Let's see if they find anything interesting. Oh, that's got a concrete slope. Well, it looks like more of the same. But then how far down do we need to go? Looks more like brick under there. Same, isn't it?
We're down to see nice stone now.
Yeah.
I'm back up here to carry on with the mirror. That's exciting, the digger turning up. This on painted furniture with the chalk paints and then dry brushed effect. So I might bring down the details on the mouldings and carvings. But yeah, I'm super impressed though. I've not done it with gold before. It dries out that way. It's quite easy to get it in those really tiny corners where I can't really wipe it off because there's not too much on it. So that's good. I'll just try and get another little nooks and crannies here. Surely these may want this carving on top. It's really bringing the details out of it. I'm getting excited now about putting the highlighting paste on in a moment. That's a bit. Just quite time consuming, but very rewarding. Gives it a really good effect.
And we see how that's brought all that detail out. And then I'm going to bring it out even further with the highlights in paste. That does definitely looks a bit like, well, maybe not. I'm not sure if that's mistletoe or not. Well, perhaps it's not. I think mistletoe has more berries than that. Maybe that is laurel. As you can see, there's some little daisy type flowers. And then there's some poppy type flowers. Anyway, it's very pretty. Look at the detail. I'm loving the effect. Right, this is the gold paste that I'm using. This I've bought in the Brico in France. There's various different styles of this that you can buy online. I've just opened the tin and it is like a gold wax. It's got like a nice sheen on that. And then you burnish it or you polish it up. This is, yeah, Libérons le patiné. Or riche means rich gold. There we are. So we only need a tiny little bit of this on a soft cloth. I'm going to try it with the kitchen mold, but I may go and find a cloth. Bits of the gold highlight paste, but I'm not super impressed because it doesn't really show up. So what I've done is I've put it on some of the raised areas and then I've left it to dry, so I'm now going to buff it to see if that helps at all. Well, I'm quite pleased with the finish on this anyway. I'm just going to give it a little buff up and then we'll do the big reveal. So I've buffed it up with a soft cloth, but it seems to be making no difference. So I don't think the gold paste on the gold is really worth doing, to be honest. Probably fine on a piece of painted furniture or something. I shall use it for something else. But I was hoping that it was gonna be a little bit lighter and a little bit shinier, but I'm quite pleased with the result of this anyway. So. But yeah, buffing it is not really doing anything. It's not making any shinier. Right, now I can do the big reveal. Right. Right, I'm undoing all the bits of plastic. Be the exciting bit. Around the edges anyway. We've still got some
some glue on here. There, how cool is that? Mm. Give this a nice clean up, that's all dusty.
Yes.
Painted and my lovely wall lights are up as well. Let's get these walls painted. This is not a straight line. I'm sorry if it doesn't look straight. It's because it isn't.
A bit noisy out here this morning, and the reason is that they've been jet washing the pavement. That looks lovely, doesn't it? That's brought all the stones up lovely. So yeah, they've been doing it in stages, working their way along the road. But yeah, having a good old clean up.
And here's the man working his way up the road, jet washing. Excellent. So much nicer. They almost look new. I'm gradually working my way up the road.
It's a little bit drizzly here, which is such a shame. We should have had much nicer weather by now. But yeah, they've been scraping up some of the courtyard already with this digger. I'm not sure if they've just stopped for a cup of tea or if that's it for the day. Is the tree coming out? Finally. Mind your bottom. It's coming to get you.